Welcome, everybody, back to Mr. Blue, aka Tommy Miller. You know it, the host with, I guess the most. I have no idea. But today, folks, we're going to come to you with a different thing here. A lot of people have been wanting me to see, me do some real life videos. Today I'm going to do a shout out to a couple of subscribers I got over the weekend. And also I will be taking a beard trimmer. You know, and go zzzz. I'm going to be taking one of them part to attempt to fix it. So stay tuned for some more clips, okay? First we're going to do the shout outs and then we're going to do the trimmer tear part. Be right back. Alright, folks, I just want to start in with I'm up to 39 subscribers. 39 subscribers, folks. With 242 videos with almost 4,300 views. And that's all possible for these fine folks like CROC342. He subscribed to me the other day. And this is his channel. He's a some of his uploads here. It's been about 2 weeks ago on his latest, looks like. He's got 28 subscribers. And he's got a farming seminar over here. Kind of skip ahead a little bit. You see him right up here. I don't have my headset on, folks, so I don't know what he's saying right now. But it looks like he's showing you how to start up Farming Simulator. So that's a good thing. And ATS Chronicles, look like. So yeah, go on over, check out his channel and stuff, folks. Once again, it's CROC342. I will have, you can pause this and get this down, but I will have it down in the description also, so be sure and check out the description. And also, Riding Mountain Gamer, folks. Riding Mountain Gamer. Look at there. That's some good art right there. I gotta do mine that way somehow. But look here, folks, 592 subscribers. 592. I wish I was up. Check out some of this stuff here. We got GoCrest, 51 episodes of GoCrest, folks. So he's up there with me. Because I only got 39 subscribers, but I got 100 something episodes of GoCrest and some of the other videos. So yeah, let's check out his playlist here. 53 on Let's Play GoCrest Rally. Also got some real life farming here, two videos, and a bunch of other videos, folks. Idaho Let's Play, mod reviews. So go check out Riding Mountain Gamer and CROC342, because they're two of the 39 subscribers. My son also finally described to me. I already thought he has, but he didn't. So, he's one of the others. So yeah, folks, check these two people out. They're part of this 39 subscribers. So anyway, next up is going to be a little vlog on electric trimmer. So stay tuned and check that out, folks. All right, folks, we're back. First of all, this is the Conair hedge trimmers, or not hedge trimmers, but beard trimmers. Got some trim some hedges with them, I guess. They're powerful enough, but they was. As you can see, the light is on right here. And I can just barely move this cord, and the light goes off. So it's
Pretty sure it's in this right here. I don't know what's wrong with it or if we can even save it. But it, somehow or another, it's broke. Now, first, I don't know if it's in this part here or if it's in this part. And as you can see, I done removed the three screws, which is on the bottom here. We got one here, one there, and one here. And yes, folks, this is still on. Just want to show you. Lights on. And it's working. There you go. You see it quit. And move it back. It starts working. So, I don't know really how to attempt to fix this. But we're going to remove the top real quick. And as you can tell, all the red hair here that I've been using it. But I don't know really what went on. But like I said, somewhere in here, right here, the connection is broke. But right here, it's good. Now with this piece here, I would hate to tear that apart just to solder these wires to these wires. But I really don't know how to go past this right here. I could probably trim the plastic away, but I'll probably end up cutting the wires. So what I was thinking about doing is come back into this part here, cut the wires, run them up to each side right here, hopefully, take them around and solder them to the back of this, and probably notch these corners out, lay the wires in. That's the only other idea I know to get this thing to work, because this is a good trimmer, folks. It works wonders. So, having said that, you know, see, lights off. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, you can see more. There's my movie done rendering. But as you can tell, it's hard to pull that out. So, I'm pretty sure it's getting a good connection right there. Let's see. So it's got to be in this part right here, but I'm going to probably just deal away from this plug and, like I said, just bring it up in there. That's the only other way I know. And then I'll put some kind of caulking or something or putty or something in here to keep these prone from touching if I can't remove them completely. So, yeah. Anyway, the power's off to this part. Throw the cord in the floor there. Turn this baby around here so I can work on it. Right-handed, by the way. Just going to kind of ease a Phillips screwdriver under each side. I don't want to touch both of them because this battery is still good. So, we cross both of them together. We might have a little problem there. So we're just going to ease that out. And as you can see, hopefully you can see right there, both of those connections are still good. So if I unsolder these, I might be able to pull these prongs out. And then I can just run the wires up where the prongs was and resolder those. So stay tuned. I'll be right back. I'm gonna get my soldering gun and unsolder those, and I'll be right back. All right, folks. I've got this out from right here, and here are the prongs. So yeah, all I gotta do now is try to get these open so I can get these prongs out. But I need something to hold it with. So, of course, I forgot my pliers. So, stay tuned just for a second. All right, folks, I'm back. I got my Little needle nose there. My phone's going off again. And if I'm not mistaken, I bet that's Jason and Boo. You know, my combine drivers and stuff. Alright, I'm going to try to do this and hold it still. I know my camera ain't focusing too well. I need a new siren on. This has been so long. Come on. Kind of getting it too hot. Yeah, I say it's too hot right there. See if I can pull this out. I don't know. Getting it too hot, it's melting that board. It looks like it started to fall through. So, let me try it one more time here. It don't be fast enough. Whoa. I'm kind of melting it out. I'm using, I don't know if you can see from right there, camera focus. That webcam don't want to focus too good. This is thin, so maybe I can kind of pull it apart. Ah, there we go. I don't want to lay down on my mat, and I don't want to lay it on the towel either. This thing is hot, folks, so. I got some of the solder off. I don't know if I melted it or not. It's not going to be very easy. Folks, I'm going to work on this and I'll be right back, okay? I'm trying to get a little leeway. All right, folks, I managed to get one out. Got one more to go. All right, folks, as you can see here, here's the two pieces, but bad news here and here. I guess it got so hot, got brittle, and it busted on me. So, that theory of doing that is out of the question. But, folks, I might be able to solder the wires to these and push them back up in here a little bit, put some black tape around them or liquid tape, and because it's got some holes here. So that's my next objective. So yeah, let me get this mess cleaned up and we'll go to that. All right, folks, I'm back. Now as you can see right here, it's got a groove. Okay, that groove goes in just like it right there. So what I need to do is keep this just like this. This side of this wire goes to hot, this side goes to negative. So I'm laying it flat down. Taking my trusty little box cutter here. And I got to split the wires. I'm not gonna go too far. I'm gonna pull them apart up to in here. So now, for me not to get this confused, I'm just going to do one wire at a time. So that was like that. So that wire is on that side. So this is going to be the hot. Pulled it back quite a bit, as you can see. And take my little snips I got here. And I don't want too much. I just want just enough where I can put some solder on it. Actually, that's probably too much right there. I don't know if you can see it or not. Yeah, it's about a quarter. I should have had about 1/8. Like these over here. I'm going to twist these around. Alright, I got to get something to hold this down so I can put some solder on it. I'll be right back. Alright, folks. Got my soldering on. I'm about to move this out of the way. I got this saw blade here. It's about the only thing I could find. I actually put this on that wouldn't do too much damage. Now what I want to do, I want to warm this wire up a little bit so this solder will stick to it. But I don't want wire up or heat up too bad. I can't even talk. Uh-oh, phone's starting to go off. Yeah, get some more here. This is something I'm not good at because I got to shake so bad. As you can see, I just got a big old pile of bubble there because it wasn't hot enough. I'll come back over here. I let that melt, get back on it. Alright, it should be enough. Now, since I got that done, I'm going to swing this around so I can get to it. Now, this is going to be the hard part. See if I can do this way. Gotta get both of these hot without melting the wires. And one way you can tell you're getting it hot enough, it starts burning your fingers, then you get it too hot. I really need a new soldering iron. I got this and charcoaled over. One of them's starting to heat up. I'll get something to press that down with here in a second. Come on, baby, get hot. I might have to eat something here, folks. I'm getting a good contact. Usually I have to go around scraping this off, charcoal off of it, so I get a good contact. Alright. And I ain't good doing this anyway. And like I said, my hands where I shake. Now see there? It started going right through it then. Oh yeah. Now you gotta be careful, folks, with a soldering iron, and watch where you lay it. Alright, it's not the best contact in the world, but it's connected. I'm just gonna let that cool. And we gotta get around here to the other side. That wire over that way. And once I can cut this one off. Now I hope I went back far enough, because if not, I'm not doing no good. And as far as what I mean in that, if this is broke somewhere in here, I just not done no good at all. Like I said, we want just a little bit of this. About like that should do. And then I'm gonna put this back up. And now once again now, I'm laying a metal blade across two wires. This is gonna be a no-no. So I'm gonna have to put something under that to keep it from contacting. And I don't see nothing. See, this piece here is plastic, so I'm going to use it right in there. I'm going to keep that. Whoa. Turn it around the other way. That way I'll keep that from contacting metal. And we don't have to worry about it touching. And once again, I got to take and put some. Let me do that first. I'm going to take and put some solder on this part here. I need something to hold it down. So I'm going to use these pliers. Get my solder here. As you can see, those wires are heating up quite fast. Alright, I know y'all may not be able to see because my camera is not focusing for some reason. Cheap old webcam, I guess. It does the job, just not up close. Should have done this with my phone, but y'all getting a majority of the idea here. Like I said, I gotta keep those two from touching. So I'm just going to do half and half like this, I guess. And I need something to put on that to hold it down in place. Might be still a little warm. But it's usually pretty good with solder. It cools off. Cools off pretty fast. Uh-oh, almost had it where I needed it. And I let go. Alright, we're going to try this again. Just gotta get both of the solders hot. Oh yeah, I think that's a good connection there. And when you see the solder kind of fizz back over, you know it's cooled down enough to hold. And then folks, I think we're almost good to go with this. Yeah, that's good and tight. Alright, now what I need to do, I'm going to test this. So it had some juice left in there, so that's why I'm glad I didn't turn it on or let them touch. Let me plug this up real quick, folks. Alright, now this is probably going to, if you're holding this down, just hold right here where the battery's at. Little switch right here. Oh, look at that, folks. Working like a charm. Working like a charm. Okay, now you want to unplug. Always unplug. See, I'm unplugged. But don't forget, you still got juice right here that might be enough to shock you. And we don't want that. All right, move all this stuff back out of the way. Over here. And folks, to make sure these don't touch, this is called liquid tape. It's this electronic liquid tape. Same thing as black tape. It's just a little amount of pretty tight. It's kind of like black tar. So I don't want a whole big gob of this. I don't want it dripping everywhere. But I do want everything coated pretty good. Oh, shoot. See, I just touched the iron over. Get the back side real good. Yeah, make sure you get it all the way around. Yeah, move kind of quick because this stuff tends to dry pretty quick on you. It won't dry to the touch, but it'll get cocky and clog up your bottle. Now, I'm going to let this dry for a little bit. I'm going to put some of this clips together while I'm waiting on it dry, so I'll be right back. All right, folks, I'm sorry I didn't let you see me putting this back together, but it's really not that much to it. I will lift this up so y'all can see. Pretty much all I got is black tape with liquid tape. Real good. And got them laid in there. Best way where they won't move. And this sponge is going to compact that down where it won't move. And let me get this back on here real good. Alright, it's not going to move very much. So what I'm going to do is take this stuff that's left and just kind of push up the, well, there are kids probably watching. I'm pushing it up in here. I ain't going to say what. They say the booty hole, but yeah, might be kids watching. All right, that's good and tight there, folks. You know what I mean? Uh-huh. You know what I mean, Vern? Good and tight. Uh-huh. I'm going to flip it over. And I'm going to insert this back screw first. Good. It went in good. And then this screwdriver is kind of tight in this hole here, too. So, yeah. But it will fit. Just can't force it. You know what I mean? Might break it. Okay, I must not have it in the hole because it's not tightening up. just lovely. Just lovely. Okay, gotta flip it back over and restart over. Well, I don't know. I can't pry that apart. Let me grab these other two screws. My fingers can't hardly pick them up, so small. Wow, look at there. They both went pretty good. I'm going to have to put quite a bit of pressure down on it to get it to tighten. One of the Phillips heads not quite right. Okay. That and snugging up. Got loose. Okay, it's snug right there. Okay, that is snug. I don't know why this one ain't snugging up. Okay, right there is about the tightest. I don't know why it's not catching. They look like they was all the same. Folks, y'all, see, I didn't cover my air conditioner up over the winter. Of course, I've been using it every other day, and these gnats get so bad that that one's not tightening up. That's not good. But it's down in there. I don't know. It just keeps turning, so don't know about that. But there it is. It's back together. With this here, I can probably get some super glue and kind of push that in a little bit, super glue it. And see, that's pretty tight right there, folks. So, but yeah, I can super glue all that, and it'll be good and steady. And plus, it'll help hold the wires, too. So here I'm going to grab the plug here, plug it back up, check out, see how it went. Oh, get my solder over there. All right, here we go. Look at there. On, I mean off, on, off, on. I don't know what this is. I don't know what that button's there for, but that goes in and out. Probably see it better on this side. Makes it a little bit longer, and that takes all the way out to the end. It's working, folks. And the light's on now. Wiggle the wires. All right, that's trying to come out, but I will put some super glue around that so it'll harden up, and the wires won't be able to pull out, which they're snug right now. They'll go back and forth just a little, but not much, folks. So that's going to wrap up how to fix electric trimmer. I don't know, you can't see the hair there. But anyway, folks, it does work. I don't even see this. See, there it goes. All right, stay tuned for the tail end. I'm going to add one more clip, and that'll be the end of it. So about 3 more minutes of this video left. So stay tuned, folks. All right, folks, that wraps up this video. I hope y'all liked it and enjoyed it. A little bit different. Something I don't usually do, but I'm going to try to start doing a little small projects at least. Maybe every other week or every week, do at least one. Try to. Don't hold me to it, but I'm trying, folks. I'm trying. Hit this like button. If this video gets a lot of likes, I'll start doing a lot of videos like this, but if not, I'm going back to my farming sim, folks. I'd much rather play with a tractor than have to do one of these. But it's all right. As you can see, the light's still working. Is this my hands? I got arthritis in my hands real bad. I got some of that liquid tape on my finger. Done dried. Always on the wrong finger, too. Well, anyway, folks, thank you for watching. Thank all my subscribers, new and old. Wasn't for y'all, wouldn't be here. Just hit that like button, share me with your friends. If you haven't subscribed already, hit that subscribe button, post notifications if you already have. And folks, I guess I'll see y'all next time. But like I said, down below, hit the like button. If I get over 20 likes on this video, I'll make another one. How's that? That work? Gotta be 20 likes now. Also, mine went blank. Ain't that something? I guess it must have been a lie. Ever heard that say that? Oh, this is what. Folks, kids, do not play with these kids. They're very dangerous. And also, I am not an electrician, certified electrician. I've been doing electrical work all my life, ever since I was probably 19, 20. Not all my life, but you know what I mean. Done some work up in town for a couple buildings. No, they have not burned down yet. So yeah, do not try this at home, folks. Kids, please, please be with an adult when you do something. This is very dangerous. And having said that, folks, like I said, 20 likes, and I will make another one. Okay? Hit the like button. See y'all later. Thank you for all y'all support. And don't forget about, if you do want to support my channel, I have a PayPal link down below in the description. You can help me out if you want to. Not obligated to, folks. Every little bit helps, though. Even if you just watch my video, that's helping enough. All right, I done took enough of y'all's time. Y'all have a blessed day. Good night, wherever you are. Good day, whatever. See y'all next video, if 20 likes. Bye.